हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू स्टैंडर्ड 10th ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर 5 पार्ट 2 नेचुरल वेजिटेशन एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ। इन द अर्लियर लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द वेजिटेशन ऑफ ब्राजील कंट्री। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इंडिया एंड इट्स वेजिटेशन। Following types of forest are found in India. In regions which receives more than 200 mm of rainfall on the average, along with abundant sunlight, evergreen forests are found. So by now you must have realized that good amount of rainfall, that is more than 200 mm of rainfall and abundant of sunlight, wherever this condition prevails, there evergreen forest grows. The leaves of the trees in this forest are broad and green. So they are always green and the leaves are broad. So broad leaves are found to teak leaves or mahogany, rubber, rosewood, etc. The trees have hardwood, heavy and durable. Durable means the wood which lasts for longer time. Hardwood, so which cannot be decayed so very fast, and it is heavy with weight. For example, mahogany, rosewood, rubber, etc. Also, there are various types of creepers found here. So creepers goes above the trees and they spread on top of the trees. Highest biodiversity is found in this forest. In regions receiving rainfall between 100 mm to 2000 mm in India, those places deciduous forests are found. Deciduous forest is a place, is a forest where during the, before the winter, the trees shed their leaves. Such forest is considered as deciduous forest. In dry season, trees shed their leaves so that water is not lost due to evaporation. So during the summer, the heat is quite a lot, and therefore before the summer, these trees shed their leaves and then a new shoot starts coming up, and therefore the water which is kept reserved by the tree, or which registered by the, which is stored by the tree, is not lost during the summer season. For example, teak, bamboo, banyan, peepal, etc. are the trees found in this forest. So second type of forest we have seen, deciduous forest. First type we have seen is the evergreen forest. The third type of forest in India is regions that receives less than 500 mm of rainfall and experience dry summer for a long period of time. In India, thorny and shrub type of vegetation is found. So third forest is thorny and shrub vegetation, or the forest. The leaves are small in size. For example, catechu. Catechu means the tree which has lot of thorns on top and small leaves, and The bark of the tree is very useful. In they use along with the lime, and it is eaten with the pan, so that your tongue becomes red. So that is considered as gratitude, which is called as in Hindi katha or Marathi kath. Acacia, khesri, these are the varieties of trees, and varieties of cactus like aloe vera and agave, etc. So there are quite a many cactus varieties are found in desert region and dryad and semi-arid region. Then in the swampy areas, for example, in the marshy areas of eastern coastland, that is from West Bengal to Bangladesh, we have Sundarban region. This region has swampy areas. In swampy areas, estuaries and lagoons near coastal areas having saline soil and moist climate, coastal type of vegetation is found. They are called as mangroves or Sundarbans in India. So Sundari trees grows over there on a large scale, therefore it is called Sundarban. The wood of this tree is oily, light and durable. So mostly this wood is been used to make boats and small boats and all, so that this wood is very useful. In the Himalayas, three types of forest are found according to the altitude. Altitude means the height. In areas located at the highest altitude, seasonally flowering trees are found. So at the highest altitude. In the region with medium altitude, coniferous trees like pine, deodar, fir, and at the foothill, the third type of forest is mixed type of forest is found. So on top, right on top of the high altitude, flowering trees, middle altitude, deodar, fir, pine, etc. And at the bottom, in the deciduous and coniferous, both are mixed, that is mixed type of forest. Here the proportion of sal trees is higher. So sal wood is very good for making furnitures and use for building purposes. It is next to teak. Teak is the best, and then afterwards sal. So sal is grown on a large scale in the foothills of Himalaya. In this way, my dear student, we have seen the part of India and its vegetation. Please study the part, answer the questions, draw the map neatly, fill the map, and next time we are going to study Brazil and wildlife. So till then, goodbye. Have a nice day.